Good morning, students. I welcome you all to your English class. So today the day is Monday and today's date is 3rd of May 2021. So let's begin with our English class. So today's topic is My English, My Canvas English course book, chapter number 2, The Champa Flower. So The Champa Flower is a very beautiful poem that has been written by Rabindranath Tagore. And for this you have to open page number 15. So the poem is on page number 15 and 16 and 17 we will do the references. Next. So can you all guess which flower is this? Yes, you are correct, children. This is Champa flower. So this is the flower about which the poet has written a beautiful poem. So let's get started. So first, as I begin the poem, I need to introduce you to the poet who has written this beautiful poem. So this beautiful poem has been written by the famous poet, that is Rabindranath Tagore. So let's see, who was Rabindranath Tagore? Rabindranath Tagore was a great Indian poet. He was born on 7th of May 1861 at Jorashanko in Kolkata. His parents' name was Maharshi Devendranath Tagore, that was his father, and Sarada Devi was his mother. He took his education at home under private teachers for various subjects. He started writing poems in his very early age. He is still a famous poet as he wrote thousands of poems, short stories, songs, essays, dramas, etc. Both he and his works are famous all over the world. He became the first Indian who received the Nobel Prize in 1913 for his great writing named Gitanjali. So that's a novel. He was also a philosopher, a painter, and a great patriot who composed our national anthem titled as Jana Gana Mana. Yes, you are right. He is the writer of, or he is the composer of our national anthem Jana Gana Mana. Now, come to page number 15. So here we will be starting with the poem. So chapter number 2, The Champa Flower. So I am reading the poem. Supposing I become a champa flower just for fun. So the poet is saying that he wants to become a champa flower just for fun. And grew on a branch high up that tree and shook in the wind with laughter and danced upon the newly budded leaves. Would you know me, mother? So what he wishes to become? He wishes to become a champa flower and he wants to dance with the wind and he wants to be on the branches of the tree where the leaves have just started budding up. Budding means growing. Yes, the new leaves have come up. So he is asking his mother, if I become a champa flower, would you be able to recognize me? Would you call, baby, where are you? And I should laugh to myself and keep quite quiet. I should slyly open my petals and watch you at your work. So you will search here and there and you will not be able to find me and you will keep on shouting, baby, where you have gone, where you have gone. And what will the child do? The child will remain quiet and it will remain quiet and slyly means cunningly. It knows that his mother is calling, but he will not give her the answer. I should slyly open my petals. slowly it will open its petals and watch you at your work, and it will watch that mother is doing her work. When after your bath with wet hair spread on your shoulders, you walk through the shadow of the champa tree to the little court where you say your prayers, you would notice the scent of the flower but not know that it came from me. When after the midday meal you sat at the window reading Ramayana and the tree's shadow fell over your hair and your lap, I should flung my wee little shadow onto the page of your book just where you were reading. But would you guess that it was the tiny shadow of your little child? So what the poet is saying, so beautiful, see. So after mother takes her bath, she opens her hair and the hairs are falling on her shoulder, and she comes out with the things for offering the prayers to the court. Court means the in front of the house, the open place where she comes and she passes from below the shadows of the champa tree and she goes to the place where she is going to offer the prayer, and she can smell the sweet smell of the flower, but she is unable to find out her child. Yes. Then after that, after the lunch, that is the midday meal, okay, after the lunch she sat at the window. What she does, she sits by the window and she reads the famous epic, that is Ramayana, and when she is reading the book, she puts the book on her lap and she is reading, and what will happen, the tree, the shadow of the champa tree will fall over her hair and her lap, and I should flung my wee little shadow, and flung means the child will throw, okay, flung means throw its little shadow over the pages of his mother's book just where she is reading the book. So at that time he is asking the question to his mother, so will you be able to find out where I am, or it is the shadow of your little child? Now see, so beautiful instances. Next one. When in the evening you went to the cowshed with the lighted lamp in your hand, I should suddenly drop onto the earth again and be your own baby once more and beg you to tell me a story. Where have you been, you naughty child? I won't tell you, mother. That's what you and I would say then. So what he's saying, then he is talking about the evening time. So what will happen in the evening time? So we are talking about the time where there was no electricity. That is why the mother is coming the mother is going to the cowshed with a lighted lamp in her hand. And what the child will do? The child will suddenly fall down or drop from the tree to the earth, and it will again come to its own, come to his mother, and he will beg his mother to tell him a story. But the mother will be able to find the child, and she will ask where you were hiding, my naughty child. She will say, I won't tell you a story. Yes. So that is a very very close conversation that is going on between the mother and the child. So now the mother is angry, now the child is trying to pamper his mother so that she doesn't remain angry any longer and tells him a beautiful story. So you see, this beautiful poem has been written by Rabindranath Tagore. Yes. and the new words. Now let's come to the new words. So the new words are budded. Budded means began to grow. Then we have slyly, that is cunningly. Next, flung is throw. Wee means small, and cowshed means a place where the cows are kept, right? So children, now come to page number 17. In page number 17, you see A1. Mark the sentences or statements as true or false. So if it is true, you will write T. If it is false, you will write down F. Okay. So number 1, the speaker wants to become a hibiscus. No, it did not want to become a hibiscus. It wanted to become a champa flower. So first one is F. It is false. Number 2, when his mother calls out to him, the speaker wants to keep quiet. Yes, that is correct. So it's true. Number 3, his mother walks to the court to say her prayers after breakfast. No, after she takes the bath. So it is false. Number 4, the speaker's mother reads the Ramayana after dinner. No, after the lunch. So it is also false. Number 5, in the evening, the speaker's mother goes to the cowshed. Yes, it is correct. So it is true. So for poems, as you all know, we do not do the question answers. Come to B1 under vocabulary. See here, tick the correct synonyms of the word or words given below. So synonyms means the words that has the same meaning. Okay. See here, number 1, earth. Earth will be land, not Mars. Okay, it will be a land. Number 2, beg. Beg is to request. Number B, beg is to request. B option. Number C, notice. Number 3 is notice. Notice is to see. It will be B option. So 1 will be a land. 2 will be B request. And 3 will be notice is to see. That is option number B. Okay. So I hope so you all enjoyed the class. I hope so you have enjoyed the poem. So you are going to read the poem thoroughly, and your homework will be to write down the full poem in your English text copies, and you will draw a beautiful picture of the mother. Yes, anyone. There are 2-3 pictures, any picture related to the poem. Okay. So thank you, children, for the class. Stay home, stay safe, and take care.